Hello guys, KP Shamino here with a new video for Russian Fishing 4, and I'm still at the new lake. And in the previous video, it was about my brown trout. Somebody said to me how you need to do the jig step in this place. It's really strange, but it works. I thought it was a bug because I had to do when I was like shift reeling in, but it seems it works what he was saying, and it works really well to catch fish too. So I'm going to show you guys how you need to do it. So it's very strange, but you need to go maximum speed, so you guys can see it here. And yeah, you just reel in 2-3 turns around on your reel, and you are going to get all the time jig step. And I already got today this fish. This is normal for asp, so I got 6.2 asp, but that's normal because an asp, they like the retrieve very fast. But still, if you check the fish that I got, so this is in like 30 minutes, and I had a night in between, so it's unbelievable. And what I'm going to show you guys is how you need to do it, and then we are going to fish a little bit. It's going to be a little bit a testing video. So at the moment I'm just fishing with the Blue Hunter, and I think that's the one series, yeah, the 1001. And what I'm going to do is we are just going to start at the right because it's now getting daytime. I think it's now one of the best days that you can have. So we are just going to start here from the right to the left, and we are just going to check how it works. So here in the 3 meter hole, we are going to start a couple of throws in this one. So what you need to do is, I hope it works here too, because sometimes it doesn't work. I think it has to do with stuff. So what you need to do is, it's very strange because it goes really fast, check. So you just start reeling in and then you stop. And then you need to wait for the bottom. If it does not come, you cannot do a jig step. Yeah, there you go. 1, 2, 3. Check. 1, 2, 3. It's crazy that it works here. But yeah, maybe it's because of the current or something. Because I thought at the start this was a bug, because I already saw it a couple of times when I just wanted to reel in. But you catch a lot of fish this way too, because yeah, you are doing a presentation, you know, it's a program. The presentation is always better than not the presentation to get fish. And let's have a look that we can get the fish here. I did not get the brown trout with this method. I'm not sure that they are fast enough, but we will see how it goes in the video. So I hope that I'm going to catch some fish. Yeah, there you already go. It's crazy, this technique. I'm not sure it's intended. I hope it's intended, because if this is the solution to get fish in this lake, I think a lot of more people are coming here. And this is a pike, or is it a chub? Yeah, it's a chub. So that's one cast, one fish. And I'm just going a little bit more to the left. Then I'm going to this rock. Then I'm going to the rocks that are on the far left. And we are just going to do the entire hole in this video. So let's have a look. Yeah, oh, this is a okay. Already thought so, because I was like, whoa, I'm still in the reeds on the other. Yeah, you need to watch it with this lake, because I throw to the other side of the area. So let's try to get the jig step back going. Here we go. And since my cat just opened the door. Yeah, it's crazy. It's crazy that this can work. But yeah, I'm not really a specialist in jig stepping. So maybe that's a solution. Maybe we need to rethink what we always do. But I know in the past, the asp was always very eager to get a lure that goes really fast. So therefore, it's not that simple to get it with trolling. But if you go a little bit faster, the asp is going to bite. And the chub seems to like it too. Yeah, check another fish. It's unbelievable. That's now 2 casts on 2 different places. And every time I got fish, okay, it's not the biggest fish. It's not that I got, but yeah, I got an asp of 6.2. That's at the moment a body record in other regions. And what is this? Yeah, it's another chop. Check. No, it's an eye. So now we are going a little bit to the left, so to the rocks here. Here I got my ASP, the 6.2. So I think I was between the reeds here. So let's do a couple of throws in the reeds. Was it here? No, I think it was here. So let's try a couple of throws here. Yeah. I think he was stuck behind the rock. So full cast again. So that's 2 on 2. You guys can see it. 2 throws, 2 fish, almost 1 kilogram eight, almost 1 kilogram chub. Let's go again. Yeah, and there is right away the jig step. Yeah, and before I forgot, I want to thank the guy that said to me the technique to do this. Normally I say it at the start of the video, but I was really excited because yeah, I got a really nice fish, and that's very rare. And then I got the trophy roach too right away. So yeah, it was my RNG was right up for this night. So I was really happy. Yeah, and there is my beeping going off. At the moment, I got a very, very heavy setup out. Maybe I can show you guys that really quick too. With live bait, with the perch, I bought here 2 perches with some gold. And so every time I hear the beeper, because there is one with the mayfly out too, check. Yeah, it's unbelievable. That's 3 on 3, and this is a nice fish. This is once again an ASP. Because I'm making so much money at the moment, yeah. Because at the moment I'm fishing with the 9.8 pure fluoro, so 300 meters. I will show you guys really quick. He's stuck behind the rock. I hope it's not a Tamon, because the main problem is if this works for the Tamon too, I think that I know how I need to get them. But I don't hope I get them on this setup. I think that fish is stuck behind the rock, yeah. Let's have a look. Oh no. Am I snagged? No, it's just a fat fish, I think. Oh, this is going to be a good fish. Come on, move a little bit. I don't think his snagged is in front of the rock, no? Is it maybe a catfish? Because this behavior was just the same as the ASP, and then it start moving. Is it already? Yeah, and I cannot jerk with the rod, so that means that I'm not snagged. This is a fish. So let's go a little bit on another angle. Maybe I can pull the fish out of the rock. I think this is a catfish. Yeah, it's a catfish. It's just a stone. It's not a rock. It's just the fish. Yeah, he's not coming in. Let's get some tea. Yeah, I think it's a catfish. Yeah, this is a catfish. I'm almost 100% sure. The problem is you need to lift them from the bottom, and that's a big problem. And you know what I'm going to do? Fuck this shit. I'm going to get my feeder first. Because I got a bigger chance. Yeah, the taming is not like this. The behavior is a lot different. So here you can see this is the mayfly, and at the right here I got my live bait, so the perch out. And this is not a bad fish. Check the bending of the rod. Let's hope it's a very big brown trout or a very big grayling. Let's have a look. It's a grayling, I think. Or is it? Oh, it's a perch. Always the same. So many perches here. Yeah, they put their body in the current. And it looks like it is a very big fish, but it's not a very big fish. It's just the current that is pulling them. Okay, and my live bait is doing nothing. It's now 3 days out in the water. So I don't know. Maybe one day I'm going to get a fish on it. So let's get this rod back. I hope that the catfish is awake. Oh, that was not so good. And already got a bite once again. Jesus Christ, it's very active at the moment, the lake. Maybe they finally put fish in it. And why is this not moving? Okay, come on. I need to get him from the bottom, or this catfish is not going to move. But the problem is with the 9.8 kilogram line, it's not so easy. Even a 5 kilogram catfish is going to give a lot of fighting with this setup. Or maybe I'm pulling the rock out of the water, that's possible too. Maybe I just hook the rock and he thinks he's a fish. But I think he's coming now. Yeah, I think he's coming off the bottom now. Because the clicking is now less. You guys can hear it. It's only clicking at the end of the jerk. Come on, fishy. It's so strange, this fish. Is it maybe a zander behaves like this too, and they are sitting here too? So I'm not sure what it is. Yeah, and I just wanted to show you guys a little bit the jig step technique that you need to do here, and then I hook a fish like this. Yeah, and it's not moving 1 inch, you know? Okay. Time to move a little bit more to the right, because this is not normal. So let's go all the way to the end, because I still think he's stuck on the rock. I think it just bugged. Just a normal fish. Okay. Yeah, and here we go. Told you guys it. Just a normal fish. It was just bugged behind the rock. It doesn't seem like it because my line went into the water before the rock, but yeah, here you go. And it's not even a fat fish, check. But I think it's an Esper chub. So that's not bad. So that's three fish in three casts. Yeah, very sorry for that, guys, for the time. It's not bad. It's even a zander. Yeah, a zander 1.5. So let's try it again. And then we are going to move to the next spot a little bit further. So let's do another throw with a special jig step method. Okay, here we go. Yeah, that's 4 on 4. It's so crazy. It's unbelievable. So I don't think it's a bug. It's intended. That's how you need to fish on this lake. So you need to go very fast. And that's how you need to get the presentation jig step, and it activates a lot of fish. Oh, is he going? No. Ah, come on. Come, jump over the rock. Yeah, good job. Okay, one more throw on this side, and then we go to the other side, and then we are going to try it in the deep holes. I'm not sure it's going to work in the deep holes, and this is a perch, I think. No, is this a brown trout? Yeah, brown trout. So that makes me very happy. So you can get the brown trout with this technique too. Check this. Yeah, and I'm having fun at the moment now. I hope it's not a bug and they keep it like it is, because it's going to attract a lot of more people to this place, because at the moment this place is dead. I was watching the streamers. I think 21, 25 people were streaming, and one guy was here. There is nobody in this lake anymore because the bite rate is way too low. But if this is the solution, I think a lot of guys are coming back. Okay, let's focus a little bit. And it seems that now the current of the river is taking my line not so far to the left. The main problem now is that it's already 10:30 a.m. Yeah, checked. Oh, damn it, man. It's so good at them. They are going to nerf this so hard. I know that already. It's so good. It's unbelievable. That's 5-6 cast, and I got 5-6 fish. And he's going once again to the rock. And this is once again a nice fish. Check the bending of my rod. Yeah, and he goes right. Ah, come on. Come, fishy. They are always going behind that rock. Yeah. Let's have a guess what kind of fish this one is. It's a pike, I think. Is it a pike or a zander? No, it's a small zander. Once again, a zander. So five casts, five fish. So that's not bad. And once again, a nice one, 1 kilogram. Okay, I said to you guys it was 2 casts ago, the last cast. But now that I'm finally getting fish, so I'm going to do one more, and then we are going to the holes. Throw a couple of times in the holes to ch yeah check. It's a yeah, it's crazy. This is a perch, I think, very small fish. But I'm very happy that you can get with this method the brown trout too. I'm not hoping that I'm going to hook a taimen with this setup, because it's not going to work. I can. Oh, it's an asp again. Yeah, I got asp here, so they are sitting here. By the way, I didn't change anything. I'm just fishing with this. So I only got 128 meters. I just wanted to test that higher test on the fluoro line is going to give me less fish. But you guys saw it already in the answer, or the fish that I caught. It's just the same. And why is this audio so high once again? Okay, this is better. So I didn't change anything with the previous video, just a little bit higher test. This is not a suitable setup, to be honest, because if I hook in a trophy asp, I'm going to be fucked. I need to go with the braid line, and I'm going to do that, because if I hook another fish that is stronger. So here, this is very cheap, 12.5 kilogram. I got now 300 meters on my P series. And then I just put like a carbon leader under it, a fluoro leader under it, 9.7, and there you go. So now this problem is solved. So an asp, nothing can spoil me anymore here in this lake besides the taimen. So just to be safe, because that setup was not really good. I just was testing some stuff, and yeah. So here we go again. Now we are at the left of the rocks. So let's have a look what we can do now. Can I get the G step, please? Oh, I got a bite. No, it's not live bait. That's a pity. I'm always excited because if it is live bait, most of the time it's a very good fish because it's a perch. And let's have a look. Is this a perch again on the mayfly? What is this? Check! It's a mussel! River mussel, what the fuck? Yeah, the moment that you start catching that kind of crap, it's time that you go to sleep, I think, to be honest. Okay, let's go back to the testing. It was not a really good throw because my line is already back here. So let's have a look that I can get the jig step on the other side of the rocks here. There is a touching bottom. Yeah, there is a jig step. So that's good. So maybe we can get another fish, because if I cannot get a fish now, it's the first time that I don't have a bite. But of course, it's noon too. You always need to look a little bit to the time of the day. That's very important in this game. The temperature is really good. It's not a very hot day today. It seems that this is a little bit same like Euro. So if it is cold, the fish is biting a lot better than when it's hot. Yeah, and I don't think it's going to happen, because check where my lure is. I'm going to do a retrow. So right away to the rock, and then we are going there. Oh no, check this. Okay, I was just reeling so fast in that I didn't notice the perch. That was a perch, right? So yeah, okay. So it's 7 on 7, 7 fish. So here we go again. Speed up. Come on, G step. Oh, yep, and another fish. I think this system works really great. It's unbelievable, to be honest, the fast retrieve. It's at this pace I'm going to get like 50, 60 fish in one day, I think. And then I fought that crazy, what was it, Xander behind the rock still. I lost a lot of time. What is this? A Xander again. Okay, one more cast. Then we are going to move a little bit more to the left, deeper in the hole. So we are going to get a couple of casts here. And then we are going to the end, and then I'm going to end the video. So you guys know what you need to do to get the jig step going in this place. And I think it's going to give a lot of more fish. And I think there are going to get a lot of more big fish on the leaderboard too. Because you need to be honest, at the moment the biggest Tamen is 18 kilogram. And he can go, I think at 40 kilogram it's a trophy. So he can easily go to 70 kilograms, so that's a little bit silly at the moment, I think. That's only the biggest fish. Yeah, and there is a jig step. And now the sun is here. I'm not sure what it's going to do with the bite. Yeah, I need to say that at the left here is not so good at the right, but maybe it's just the day of the time. The day of the time, the time of the day. Come on, fishy. Yep, I was already thinking, oh, am I not going to get a fish this time? But yeah, here it is. It's not fat fish, but I think if you're a level 12 and you can fish the whole day like this, it's going to give you nice money and a nice experience. Okay, let's move a little bit more to the hole. So let's have a look where I am at the moment. Okay, I can reach the deep hole now. So maximum throw. A jig step, then I'm going to the left, and then I'm going to the end. So let's have a look that it works over here too. It's not giving me jig step. Maybe I needed to wait a little bit longer, because here it's a lot deeper. Maybe I need to wait until my lure hits the bottom. Yeah, there we go, touching bottom. I think that I'm out of the hole now. Come on, jig step. Okay, reel a little bit faster. No, it's not coming at the moment. And that's very strange, because this was a place that you could do jig step really easy. But yeah, I need to wait. Because I went too fast with reeling at the start. Okay, let's reel a little bit. Okay, let's wait. Let's put the rod a little bit to the water. Yeah, there you go. Sometimes it can help. I saw it once on a stream, a guy doing this, and it was a lot easier to get the jig step. Yeah, and here is the jig step. So it works. But I think it's going to be too late to get the fish, because the lure is almost here with me. Yeah, I don't think it's going to happen. So I'm just going to reel it in. We are going to try it again. And then we are going to move to the left place. So the first conclusion, okay, it was not so good what I did here. But the first conclusion, if we go to the deeper holes, it seems that the bite goes a little bit down. So it works really well in the shallows. So now we are going to wait a little bit. Okay, let's reel in. Let's wait. Yeah, there we go. Okay, that was a lot better, so I needed to wait a little bit. Let's have a look that I can get now a fish, and now the jig step is gone again. Yeah, there you go. Yeah, so it works here too. So the presentation, the GStep presentation is indeed working like this at the moment in this lake, and this is a very nice fish. I think it's a chub, but that's not a problem, you know. A chub pays the bills too. A chub of 1 or 2 kilograms, I think it's even 5 to 6 silver, so that's not bad. I hope, of course, it's the brown trout or maybe a small taimen, because I still need to get a taimen, but it works too in the hole. Now we are going a little bit more to the left still, and now we are going to the deepest hole. That's the 6.5 meters. So I think it's here already 6.5 meters, but it's where the number is on the map. That's what I mean. What is this, by the way? Yeah, it's another zander. Check, and a nice one. Yeah, 1.5 again. So let's go to the. So I think that every cast I got now a fish, no? Yeah. So let's go to this position. Let's go to the map. So now you can see here I'm nicely on the number, but I think this is all 6.5 meters, so it's not going to be a different. This is where I hooked my taimen that spooled me. So I'm not hoping that we are getting him back, because yeah, my setup is just the same. Okay, come on. Try to give me a G step. There is touching bottom. That's always very good. G step. Yeah, there we go. Yeah, it's gone again. I'm out of the hole, I think. It's a little bit more difficult if you need to do it in the deep water. Come on, touching bottom, please. No. Yeah, G-step, we got it. Yeah, right away a bite. Yeah, it's unbelievable in this game. Presentation is so important. Therefore, I don't get a lot of trophies when I troll around in Kyoro. It's I know that for a long time, because I think I said it in one of my videos, and you guys can see it. I got the presentation 3 seconds later. There is a fish. It's only a perch, I think. No, what is this? It's a chub. Once again, 1 kilogram. Okay. The last cast for today, guys, so you guys know what you need to do. So I got 8 casts, or 9 casts, is it even more? And I got 8 fish. So that's how you need to fish here with the spinning gear. I even got a brown trout, so you can get the brown trouts with it too. Okay, let's try to get the jig step. Yeah, there we go, right away. That's not bad. Yeah, and it's. I already got the fish on. I was thinking, damn, my jig step is gone again, but I got the fish. That's 9 on 9, so it's not bad. This is fun fishing. So sometimes guys are saying fishing is not catching, but yeah, if you don't catch fish. Yeah, at some point you think what I'm doing here in this game, you know. A game need to be fun, and if it is not fun, yeah, you do something else. And is this a perch? No, it's not a perch. It's a brown trout. Check this. The second one. Damn. Farm brown trout. It's a mini brown trout. So that's already the second one. So the last throw for today, you guys know what you need to do. So it was just a little bit gameplay, because people always ask me to show a little bit of gameplay, and that's indeed true, because most of the time I just say this and this you need to do, and that's it. But now you can see how that I test stuff. It's a lot of work and a lot of time you always need to invest, and sometimes you don't find a solution, because yeah, there is not always a solution. You always need to think there is RNG too in this game. Yeah, check. Oh boy, is this another brown trout? It's once again a very fat fish. It's so fun. I'm going to fish a little bit more, to be honest here. It's crazy. It's crazy. I got 50 fish in my keep net already in 2 days. The last 10 days I had maybe 50 fish too in this place. And what is this? Is this a chub or is this a brown trout again? I don't know. We will see. And then it's for real the last cast, guys, because it's already 30 minutes and I want to go to sleep. So let's have a look what we got here. Yeah, it takes some time because I'm throwing 60, 70 meters with this setup. So it's is this a sender again? Yeah, it's another sender. Damn, they like this. One and a half. They are all one and a half. Okay, let's throw. So that's 11, 12 fish. The last cast. So here we go again. Come on, give me G-step. Yep, there it is. Yeah, and it's gone again. Or do I got a fish on? No, I don't have a fish on. It's a little bit harder in the deep water. I need to say that. Come on, touching bottom, please. Is the last cast not going to give me a fish? Yeah, cheek step. Come on, fishy. Just give me a perch, please. Come on, do it. Yeah, it's at the moment the hottest temperature of the day. That's the problem, I think. It's 12.6 Celsius. Because we had east wind, so the highest temperature of the day is in the very late afternoon. That's normal because east wind is cooling down, it's a cooler. Yeah, and I don't think it's going to happen, guys, because I think my lure is almost here. No, it's not going to happen. Okay, but yeah, maybe I can jiggle a little bit, but I can say, guys, you guys saw it by yourself, so the testing is not bad. What kind of fish did we get? So you guys can see it here. It's the video is 30 minutes, so we started here 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15 fish. So that's 30 fish with only one spinning rod. And let's have a look what the price is. I'm not expecting a lot of money, but it was really fun fishing. And I think a lot of low-level guys. So let's have a look what did we earn here. 31 silver. So that's not bad. If I fish a little bit further, 60, 70 silver is not bad on a level 12 lake. So the moment that I started to do this technique, that was over here, the first asp I think that it was. No, it was further. So if you check in 1 hour and a half, I made 120 silver. So that's not bad. So that was it for the video, guys. How you need to do a jig step technique in the new lake. Yeah, I hope to see you guys in the next video. Thanks for watching and have fun. Bye bye.